Hello learners, welcome to environmental science course for senior secondary level in NIOS. We have already discussed about environment and its component and various ecological concepts. You can see the figure, lush green forest to cut down leads to deforestation. Observe the lush green beauty of the pristine forest. They take so little from the mother earth and give so much. They are complex ecosystems, support myriads of life forms. Humans have altered the ecosystems accordingly to their need without thinking about its consequences. Increasing human population compounded by the ever increasing need to agriculture, urbanization and industrialization needed more and more land, which is obtained by large scale clearing of forests. Deforestation has changed the scenario, resulting on into large scale environmental problems. So today's program is based on deforestation, which is lesson 9 of module 3, human impact of environment. I am Neelam Gupta, welcomes you in this program. So for this discussion we have with us Dr. Padmaja Saxena, assistant professor, Dayal Singh College, University of Delhi. Welcome you, madam, in this program.
Thank you, Neelam. During this program, we are going to discuss about deforestation, which is cutting down of trees and the land is converted for human use. After completing this lesson, you will be able to define forest and describe the shrinking of forest cover throughout the world, explain the various causes of deforestation, give examples of exploitation of forest resources, define biodiversity, give reasons for its rapid decline, express concern about the consequences of biodiversity loss, describe how deforestation is contributing towards soil erosion, flash floods and change in climate, describe the impact of deforestation on tribal communities, and define desert and explain the causes and effects of desertification with examples of desertification in India. But before going to the deforestation, let us discuss about what are forests and their benefits. Now, forests can be defined as the area with trees and other plants, including the forest floor. The trees create a special environment which in turn affect the kind of plants and animals that live in there. Forest is a complex ecosystem consisting mainly of trees that buffer the earth and support a myriad of life forms. Forest constitutes the natural ecosystems or environment and is being destroyed by men for its need and greed. 1/3 of the earth's total area is covered by forests. In India, the total forest cover is about 708.273 square kilometer, which is about 21.54% of the total area. Between the year 2015 and 17 in India, about 6.778 square kilometer forest cover is added. So, you can just go through the diagram. Now, in the figure, we can see that very dense forest, all the land is with entangled tree cover. It includes mangroves cover and the canopy density is of about 70% or more. Moderately dense forest is where all the land with tree cover and the canopy density is between 40 to 70%. The open forest here, all land with scattered trees and the canopy density is between 10 to 40%. The scrub is where the all forest land is with poor tree growth, which is mainly small or stunted trees, and the canopy density is less than 10%. The non-forest area is, which is not included in the above category, and which you can see is shown by yellow color in the slide. Now we come to the types of forests. So forests are natural, means composed of naturally grown indigenous trees, or plantation, or you may call it as man-made, where trees are grown by humans. Now, different types of forests are determined by their soil type, topography, and elevation. Following are some of the Indian forests classified on the basis of their nature and composition. Then there are evergreen or rainforests in the areas like Kerala and Northeast, deciduous forests in the plains, mountain forests, alpine forests of Ladakh, desert, or you can call them as the thorn forest as in Rajasthan, and mangrove, the marshy area. You can see in the diagram. Now, importance of forests. Humans have had a long association with forests. When humans first evolved, they were totally dependent upon forests for their food, shelter, and clothing. Even afterwards, humans remain dependent upon forests for many commodities. Forests are useful to us in many ways, some of which are, first of all, they provide habitat for wildlife. Second is, they provide resources such as timber, firewood, food, drugs, then protecting the watershed from the soil erosion, recycling of groundwater, and cycling of carbon, water, nitrogen, phosphorus, etc. Forests are renewable resource. They provide essential oils, resin, turpentine, fiber, fruit, and many more products, as you can see in the diagram. Now, trees are the prime producers for the forests. They purify and cool the air and control the climate. We have mentioned about the type of forests, which depends on the climate, soil type, topography, and elevation of that region. Now, the food chain in the forest, it consists of abiotic constituents, which includes the litter. Now, food chain in the forest consists of abiotic constituents, which includes the litter, dead organic debris, and microorganism. While the biotic constituents includes the producers, which includes shrubs and ground vegetation, consumer, which can be primary consumers like the herbivores, then the secondary consumers like the carnivores, and after that comes the decomposers, which include the microorganisms. Now, the functions of the forests. First is the timber. India and other tropical countries have abundant timber and hardwood resources. Large number of trees are commercially cut down for timber in different parts of India. Timber is used in industry as plywood, sawmilling, paper and pulp, furniture, sports goods, etc. Medicinal plants. About 40% of all the drugs throughout the world have active ingredients extracted from plants and animals. For example, quinine is derived from the bark of cinchona, which is used for the treatment of malaria. Then Taxol, a drug for leukemia, is derived from Taxus brevifolia and Vinca rosea. Then digitalis, from foxglove, is used for treating chronic heart trouble. Several other drugs as antibiotics, morphine and cocaine are all obtained from plants. Poppy is a good source of morphine, which is for pain relief. Now, aspirin, a most common and widely used medicine, is extracted from the leaves of tropical willow trees. Now, learners will discuss about deforestation. It may be defined as cutting down of trees, repeated lapping, felling, and removal of litter, which houses number of microorganisms grazers, and trampling of seeds and seedlings. Deforestation may be temporary or permanent, as forests are being cut down by human being to get land for agriculture, pasture, desert, and human settlement. The prefix D in the word deforestation means remove. Suffix ation denotes the act or state of. So, deforestation can also be defined as the removal or damage of vegetation in a forest to the extent that it no longer supports its natural flora and fauna. Now, loss of forest cover. In India, for over last 30 years, about 15,000 square kilometer is lost to encroachment and about 4,000 square kilometer area is used for industrial projects. Causes of deforestation. Cutting of wood for fuel, timber and paper industry. To get land for agricultural and commercial purposes. Grazing of domestic animals. For urbanization and various development projects. Now we will study in detail the factors that lead to deforestation. So first, the most important one is agriculture. As with the increasing population, the demand for agriculture rises and more of land is required for cultivation. The land can be obtained by cutting down forests, grasslands, marshes, and even land under water. This leads to ecological destruction and gain in terms of crop yield. When farming is done on forest land, it cannot be used for agriculture for a longer time due to depletion of nutrients, and when the treeless land is left barren, it suffers from soil erosion and soil degradation. Second is shifting cultivation. This is also called as jhum farming, which is a very old practice and a step towards transition from food collection to food production. This cultivation causes extreme deforestation, as after a few years, the nutrients of that particular land are lost. And so the farming is shifted to other fertile land. Today, shifting cultivation is practiced in central India and in northeast India like Assam, Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Nagaland, Tripura, and Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Demand for firewood. Firewood is used as a source of energy for cooking and heating. In India, in the rural area, wood is the only source for fire used by about 77% and only 9% population uses LPG in urban India. 62% of households use LPG as major fuel for cooking and 20% use firewood. Now, Karnataka is the largest producer of fuel wood in India, followed by West Bengal, Maharashtra, and Bihar. Industry and commercial use. Wood is used for furniture, packing cases, wooden boxes, paper, etc. As you can see the various uses of wood in the picture. Now, urbanization and development projects. With building of infrastructure as road, railway lines, dams, township, thermal power plants for electricity, then mining for coal, metal ores and minerals, land in abundance is required, which is attained by deforestation or cutting down of forests. One example of the above point discussed is Tehri Power Project, built at the Tehri, a town in the Garhwal region in the Himalayas. The dam is on the junction of Bhagirathi and Bhilganga rivers. it is estimated that 4,600 hectares of good forest land will be submerged under water and displacement of about 3,500 old families. Besides the mentioned causes of deforestation, there are many other causes by which the forest may suffer, which are the natural calamities like floods, forest fires, diseases, termite attack, overgrazing, etc. Forest and tribal society. The tribal societies constitute about 4% of the world's population. The tribal people have cultural, spiritual, and economic ties with a particular area. Or in other words, we can say that it can be said that tribal people protect the biodiversity and the culture, having knowledge and resource management skills. The knowledge was passed from generation to generation. They knew how to grow different kinds of food and fiber crops simultaneously on the same land and to maintain the fertility for years. The plots were left to recover the area as forest before and then to begin a fresh cycle. Now, consequences of deforestation. Deforestation affects both physical and biological components of the environment, leading to soil erosion and floods, climate change, loss of diversity. Now, we'll deal these topics in detail. So, first, soil erosion and flood. Now, due to cutting of trees, the sand is left barren and the topsoil is removed with water and wind. Deforestation has altered the rainfall pattern. Heavy rainfall may lead to flooding as trees prevent sediments runoff and forests hold more water than farms and grasslands. Learners, you must have seen that in the year 2017, there were floods in Jammu and Kashmir, which was because of the deforestation. And recently, you must have heard about the floods in Kerala. Learners, you must be aware of the recent floods in Kerala. You witnessed the worst flood in the century with a death toll of about 322 people and damage of about 19,000 crore recorded in the state. The reason is flash flooding when a downpour proves so heavy that the underlying ground cannot cope with the sheer amount of water it is exposed to and becomes saturated before it has a chance to drain away. Common in low-lying areas, flash floods can also be caused by an intense concentration of rain from thunderstorms on dry soil, unaccustomed to ready absorption. Just 6 hours of rainfall can be enough to overwhelm the earth in built-up areas. It can be due to sewers overflow and the street gush like rivers, ferrying debris and in extreme cases running with enough water to lift and carry away cars. You will study various types of disasters in lesson number 12, which is disasters and their management. Now, the second point is climate change. Forests enhance the following features of environment. Precipitation, water holding capacity of soil, regulate water cycle, maintain soil fertility by returning nutrients to the soil through leaf fall and decomposition, absorb carbon dioxide from atmosphere, thus balancing carbon dioxide and oxygen in the atmosphere. Now, greenhouse effect is also caused due to deforestation. Carbon dioxide under high concentrations acts as a serious pollutant. Along with it are the water vapors and methane. The atmosphere allows most of the visible light from the sun to reach the earth's surface. It radiates parts of this energy back as infrared radiation. This radiation is absorbed by greenhouse gases, which are named above. in the atmosphere, raising its temperature. Although greenhouse energy is a naturally occurring phenomena, but the effect is intensified by emission of greenhouse gases into the atmosphere. The entire Himalayan ecology is threatened as snow line is shrinking and perennial springs have dried up, and there is decline of annual rainfall by 3 to 4%. Then we come to biodiversity. So biodiversity is the term which is coined in 1985 by G. Rosen. Biodiversity includes all variety of life forms. It includes the number of genetic strains within a species and the number of different ecosystems in an area. Biodiversity is not static. It keeps on changing over the time. New species, they come up, while the older ones may become extinct, which is also called as evolution. India is on number 12 in mega diverse countries of the world. This is based on survey conducted by Ministry of Forest and Environment. There are about 45,000 plants, means about 7% of the world flora, and 77,000 animal species, about 6.5% of the world fauna. Now, forests being home of wildlife are important assets of aesthetic, tourism and cultural value to the society. There is a lot of concern about preserving biodiversity as it provides wide variety of products for human use and welfare. It has great potential for agriculture, medicine and industry. Some of the causes for biodiversity loss are hunting, poaching and commercial exploitation, then elimination and disturbance of wildlife habitats, destruction of habitat and life forms, domestication, use of pesticides, then pests, medical research and zoos, and introduction of new alien species in new area which threatens the indigenous species. Now, we'll come to the another topic, which is extinction of species. The species become extinct due to the loss of biodiversity. Once a species goes extinct, its chances for further evolution are lost. A species is considered extinct when no member of species remain alive anywhere in the world. The extinct species exists in museum and pictures. Threatened species. Several plants and animal species are threatened by the possibility of being on the verge of extinction, but the seriousness of the threat varies. International Union of Conservation of Nature, which is also designated as IUCN, has categorized threatened species into four categories, which are endangered, rare, deplete, and indeterminate. Endangered, when the number of species are few and its territory is very small, or both, and if not protected, may become extinct. For example, loin-tailed monkeys from rainforest and Sholas of South India. Then the rare species whose number is few or live in small areas where they can quickly disappear. For example, the great Indian bustard. Then depleted species whose numbers are greatly reduced from that of the recent past and are continuing to decrease. Animal and plants in this category can become rare or endangered. For example, clouded leopard was sold illegally in Kashmir markets for its fur, and it is now depleting. Then the fourth is indeterminate. The species which are not sufficiently well known to be assigned on specific category. For example, snow leopard, was declared indeterminate in the year 1968 and endangered in the year 1970. It is hunted for its thick fur. Now we come to the next section of this lesson, which is desertification. What is desertification? It is defined as destruction of biological potential of the land, which can ultimately lead to desert-like condition. It may be result of natural phenomena due to climate change or abusive land use. Deforestation, overgrazing, mining brings about changes in rainfall, temperatures, wind velocity, which leads to soil erosion, causing deforestation of the area. At the time of independence, 75 million hectare, which is about 22% of the land, was under forest cover. But by the year 2011, the forest cover was only 10%. Deserts support very little flora and fauna, which is specially adapted to extremely unfavorable condition. Most of the deserts have resulted from one or more of the following human activities. The first is uncontrolled and over-exploitation of grazing, indiscriminate tree cutting, which leads to drought, soil erosion, loss of fertility. Second is excessive mining in arid and semi-arid regions for mineral, coal or limestone. Then the third point is land use for agriculture leads to loss of soil fertility and soil erosion. Next, intensive and uneconomic exploitation of water resources leading to fall in water table, seepage and excessive salinization of soil. Most of the desert in India are found in the states of Western Gujarat and Rajasthan, which is about 4.34%. Then in western parts of Rajasthan are like Jaisalmer, Ganganagar, Churu, Bikaner, Jodhpur, Junjunu and Nagaur district. Now we will see the case study of the Thar desert. It's an extensive region of sandy desert in northwest India and eastern Pakistan. The area is about 805 kilometers in length and 485 kilometers in width. The rainfall is about 127 to 54 mm annually and the temperature goes up to as high as around 58 degree centigrade. Plants, the plantation is of thorny forest. Trees like khejri makes for the large areas of natural vegetation. There are about 700 species of plant with 107 species of grasses. The plant damage is largely due to overgrazing by livestock, making regeneration of the plants is very difficult. Another factor is human activities and underlying structural factors and material processes due to which the species are vanishing. Animals, Asiatic lion used to inhabit the plains of Rajasthan, Punjab in the recent past, but no existence is there after the year 1976. Cheetah, which is extinct now, was found in Kathiawad region. Other animals which are in the list of endangered species are leopard, wild boar, wild ass, Indian gazelle, blue bull and black buck. The bird species which were in large numbers are now dwindling, which are like the great Indian bustard, houbara, lesser florican. Then peafowl, being a national bird, is well protected by people. Among reptiles, two species of crocodile and turtle are restricted to Jawai Dam in Sirohi district at the foothills of Aravali. The large terrestrial reptile, the rock python, are also vanishing from the desert. So we can see that large number of plants and animals are on the verge of extinction or have vanished. The National Bureau of Social Science and Land Use Planning classified dry land region of India as arid, which is about 50.8 million hectare, semi-arid region about 123.4 million hectare, and dry sub-humid region about 54.1 million hectare. Human population pressure is the most critical indicator of deforestation. In India, 32.75% of the total geographical area is affected by various forms. Every year, to combat desertification and drought, World Day is observed on 17th of June. Learners, I think we have completed the objectives which I told you in the beginning. So that is all. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Padmaja, for sharing information related to deforestation. Before we wrap up, we would like to recap the main points, that is what you have learned. Forests are the backbone of the life forms, and the life on earth is sustained through them. There are three major functions of the forest, that is productive, protective and regulative. Deforestation of forest is caused due to shifting cultivation, demand for timber, for paper and pulp, commercial wood and firewood, and mining operations. Deforestation also causes soil erosion and floods, climate change, loss of wildlife, etc. Loss of biodiversity during deforestation is immense because several unknown species of biota is lost forever from our planet Earth. Threatened species are likely to become extinct if their environment deteriorates further. Endangered species are few in number and their homeland is very small, and any deterioration in environment can make them extinct. Depleted species are those whose number have decreased in the recent years and are continuing to decrease. Desertification is a natural phenomena, but it is often accelerated by human activities. They are uncontrolled grazing, indiscriminate cutting of forest, excessive mining, uneconomic use of agriculture land, exploitation of water resources, etc. Deforestation and desertification are two interlinked problems which have arisen from the over-exploitation of natural resources through human activities causing irreparable damage to earth. Dear learner, this is all about lesson 9, deforestation. We will come again to meet you in a new program of environmental science. Thank you.